Module 3, Cognitive Development and Appropriate Practices. In the previous module, the development and appropriate practices related to cognitive development was observed for up to 6 months. In this module, let us look further ahead and understand the practices from 6 months to 1 year. Learning outcome. To understand the concept of cognitive development and appropriate practices from 6 months to 3 years, to gain knowledge of the developmentally appropriate practices involved for the same, to apply the knowledge gained to real-life situations. Developmental milestones from 6 to 12 months. It is never easy task to understand the workings of a child's mind and for that matter, even an adult's. It's never easy to understand the thought processes of a child. Researchers have been able to understand the workings of a child's cognition by coming up with a lot of creative tasks. With more freedom in mobility by this stage, learning by exploring is a major task a child will be involved in, and hence their sense of perception, imagination is becoming more and more complex. By this stage, a child can understand the difference between living and non-living things. This is where Piaget explains the concept of animism, that is, imagining non-living things have life, can identify pictures, can perceive quantity, concept of shape, size, color, texture, all are developing. Judge the distance between the child and an object. Object permanence is achieved. Again, individual differences has to be taken into consideration. Can imitate few basic actions, can respond with gestures and sounds, can manipulate objects. Developmentally appropriate practices. Storytelling with the help of puppets. Concept of animism. Block play, role play, puzzles. Increases imagination, creativity. Have big single alphabets on single cards, which is textured. Tracing over the alphabets helps the child understand better, as they are perceiving two senses is still at its peak at this stage. Calling out to the child from a distance or keeping objects at a distance and calling out to the child to reach for it. Cause and effect games. Dump toys and allow the child to explore it. Partially hide objects and call out for the baby to find a toy. Children by this age can make mental representations of how the partially covered object will look as a whole. Taking the child to parks and small trips. Practice shapes and colors. At this age, a child can identify one or two maximum colors. Sometimes, children take a longer while to understand colors. Practicing the same every day will fasten up their ability to identify colors. Developmental milestones from 1 to 2 years. Along with cognitive development, the other developmental areas are also equally progressing and hence will have an all-round impact on the areas of development with the right kind of practices. Children are always at play and spend a lot of time observing adults around them and imitating them. Therefore, this is a very good space where good behaviors can be inculcated in the child. Some prominent development seen are able to understand and respond to language, identify similar objects, similar colors, me and you concepts are very clear, adult expressions and actions are well imitated, can identify and relate to real objects, to objects displayed in a picture, classification, seriation, differentiation are other skills evolving, enjoys hands-on experiences. Developmentally appropriate practices. Teach about body parts, talk more and use rhymes and songs to introduce concepts. Books, educative toys must be constant companions. Help the child learn to identify colors, shapes, sizes every day. Point out to the child's dress and help the child identify color. Introduce concept of matching colors, animals and young ones, similar vegetables, fruits and other simple concepts the adults wishes to choose. Encourage independence and decision making in the child by asking the child to choose their own rest, respect the child as an individual, provide choices for the games the child would like to play. Give a lot of scribble time, coloring time, messy play, clay modeling and sand play. Nature walks are best learning experiences. Allow the child to get dirty and at the same time teach the child to be responsible. Responsibility can be cleaning up toys, make the activity fun, have sing-along songs as the cleaning work is going on. Developmental milestones from 2 to 3 years. At this stage, children are becoming more and more independent. They are able to explore the surroundings around them better. Language is also developing, which gives scope for better learning. Children learn by trial and error method. Can categorize objects, stacking blocks and rings, but not orderly. Imitation of more complex adult actions like playing house, pretending to be cooking and cleaning, even helping around. Can identify their own reflection in the mirror. Simple directions like pick up the doll or wear the red shirt are easy to follow. Children won't be able to respond to too many instructions at this stage yet. Name and matching objects looks very easy for them. It's the questioning age. Developmentally appropriate practices. Simple four-piece puzzles and board games can be introduced. Encourage the child to ask questions by arousing their curiosity. Make small, noticeable changes in the child's surroundings, which will enable the child to question the changes. Role plays can be organized every day in school, which can be theme-based. Planting activity, nature science experiments, simple ones like fire needs oxygen to burn, cause and effect activities, problem solving activities, creative thinking and critical thinking activities introduce the concept of math through quantity, shapes, size. Conclusion. The adult caregiver will have to consider individual differences of each child while planning activities. A lot of patience is required on the part of the adult and must never hurry a child to complete a task or activity. Allow the child to repeat, make mistakes and learn from them. Adequate nutrition, healthy lifestyle is an important factor. Never compromise on the sleep patterns of the child or force a sleepy child to stay awake. The activities that has been given in all the modules can be adapted to both home and school atmosphere. The creativity of the caregiver plays an important role in planning developmentally appropriate practices. Both cognitive and physical development plays a crucial role in a child's life and it works hand in hand. Importance has to give to both equally as well the other areas of development which will be discussed in the next module. Thank you.